On today's Salt Lake City, I'm gonna answer a question from Twitter, and then I'm gonna get to making the hardest puzzle I can come up with. Welcome to Salt Lake City. I'm Steve, and we've just been building our Twitter account. So if you're on Twitter, follow us at Salt Lake City. In the same vein, we put out weekly videos. So if you like our content, consider subscribing. And if you like this video, please hit the like. It really helps people find us. This week, we're gonna have a giveaway. All you need to do to win is be a subscriber and leave a comment below. The question for this week is, what have you been doing to cope with all this craziness? This week's question comes from Texas Paul at CTP underscore Tex. He says, I would like to see once you make something on Illustrator or Inkscape, how do you know what to set the power or other settings at? One to cut and the other engrave. I'll be using it for leather work. I love your leather business cards, by the way. Well, thank you. We love our leather business cards too. All right, first things first, let's get the Iris box plans. Go to Thingiverse and we just go ahead and say, look up the Iris box. Here it is, laser cut Iris boxes by Jack Carter. Thank you, Jack. I'll link to this below. Such cool plans. In this Iris section, I wanted to have the Salt Lake City logo. So when you open it up, the Salt Lake City logo disappears. So let me show you how I do that. Let's go ahead and open Illustrator. Gonna go over to the files. We're gonna do the huge file. This is the file right here. Right now, this is all just cut. So Texas Paul, you wanna know how you cut and engrave? Here's the secret. You add it as a different color. You just hit Command G and that becomes a group. Because I want to put one image over the top of it, I'm going to nest these. I don't see anything that is crossing, and so we're good. So those will still cut. What we're going to do that's different, though, is we're going to go over here. I'm going to get my logo. Okay, since we're going to cut each piece individually, all we need to do is go ahead and select these groups, and we're going to change the stroke color. Let's just say red. Then we're going to take this image, going to copy, going to paste it right in the middle. Now, because that's two different colors, it's gonna come up as two different steps in the project. We're gonna hit create, we're gonna upload from file and bring it in just like we normally would. And there it is, Irisbox SMC. We're gonna delete this, zoom out. We're gonna delete everything except for what we're gonna cut on the laser right now. Center that. Next thing I'm gonna do is throw some material on the Glowforge. All right, so the design's in. I've actually got some wood in there, so you can't see the honeycomb tray underneath. So I happen to be using wood. It's not proof grade wood, but it's the same as a medium basswood plywood. So I just happen to use that. And then it goes ahead and it presets all of my settings. Now, how do you do that if maybe you're not using a proof grade? I found this website. It's just a Google spreadsheet that people keep up and maintain and has all these materials. If I'm using MDF, from Home Depot and I want to cut at full power, I want to do a speed of 145 and cut right through the MDF. One last thing I wanted to mention is that the order in which you have the steps in the Glowforge is important. That's the order in which your files are going to be cut. What I like to do is have the engrave steps first because things have a tendency to drop and change level ever so slightly when they're cut. If we engrave them, it's gonna stay the same. We have the lid ready to go in one color. That's a step one. We have some pieces in a second color. So at this point, let's go ahead and hit print. Often talking about following the steps, make sure you follow every step exactly. Well, I didn't secure the transfer tape down. It popped up. As the laser came across, it grabbed the wood and moved it out of place, and you can see that the cuts traveled a bit. I've got some extra. I'm gonna do the transfer tape again the right way, and then I'm gonna make this final piece for the box. So the piece of the box has been cut. I'm actually gonna put the box together before I cut the puzzle because I want to put it right in the box. I'm excited for this part.
as you can see, I found a snag. This looks great, except it's jammed, and I think it's because I used wood screws instead of machine screws. Almost 11 o'clock at night. I'm gonna call it good for the night. Screw everything down so it glues nice in place, and then tomorrow I'm gonna go to the hardware store and get some 12 millimeter machine screws. Box is done. I had to build this thing and take it apart about 15 times, and then I needed help to glue the inside because I've got big hands, and fitting inside with the glue just didn't quite work quite right. But this is done. Let me show you. This is actually the really hard and complicated part of the build. I love doing this. It's so satisfying. I learned a couple of things. One, I used standard SAE measurement screws, and the design that I have linked below is for metric. And so I took my Dremel and all the parts that are channels that the screws travel through, I Dremeled those out a little bit, works beautifully. And then I went ahead and for Texas Paul, I etched the logo in here. So if you like a box like this, and the puzzle we're about to do, which is actually surprisingly the easy part, here's what you have to do. Be a subscriber and comment below. That's it. What kind of crazy things? Derek likes to do puzzles. I like puzzles. What crazy things have you been doing to stay sane in the midst of all this craziness? Now I'm gonna go design it. I'll show you how I'm gonna do that. It's really easy. There's a jigsaw puzzle generator. This is a piece of 20 by 12 acrylic, quarter inch thick. I want it to be nice and thick so the pieces really pop together. I'm gonna throw this into the Glowforge and cut it. The part that's gonna take the longest here is not the cutting. Cutting on the Glowforge is fast. Engraving takes a long time. I'm not a monster. On this Acrylic, I am going to put a logo of Salt Lake City down here. Consider that some false hope.
We want to generate a puzzle. Okay, so it comes out to being a 375-piece puzzle. Now, the cool thing is I can play around with it. So now we're just going to go ahead and download the SVG, and we're going to create. Okay, so this is the puzzle that we've got. So you can see it's bigger than the piece I have down in there. So we're going to zoom out a little bit. So let's zoom out. Okay. And what we're going to do is we're going to shrink it down a little bit. I have thick acrylic in there. So because I have thick acrylic, it's the same as what Glowforge already uses. It knows already the settings that I need to use. It's going to take an hour because this is some pretty intricate cuts. And because it's thick acrylic, it's going to take a second to go through. So without further ado, let's get cutting.
All right, so this is going to be the hardest part of the puzzle right here. Weeding. If it's going to be a clear puzzle, it's got to have clear pieces. So we have to pull the backing off of each one of these pieces. Fortunately, I have some assistance. Derek?
Yes, Steve?
It's been a couple videos. Welcome back.
Thank you. It's good to be back.
I have something for you. You don't know what it is.
This is true.
Are we all agreed that we're feeling a little bit of stress these days?
Yeah, I think that's safe.
A little bit of stress. Yeah. I know of some of the ways you deal with stress. Mm-hmm. So, I made something for you.
Okay.
Actually, we all helped.
Okay.
I'll be right back.
In the meantime, I'll narrate this awkward pause. I truly don't know what he is about to bring me.
Here it is.
It is what appears to be a puzzle box of sorts. Oh, that's cool.
It's not completely transparent. There's an image on it.
This was made entirely using the Glowforge, I assume. Okay.
All the Glowforge was about 10 screws in it and some glue.
Teeny acrylic. So first of all, an acrylic puzzle is pretty diabolical. Here you go. For the next 2.5 weeks, here's something for you to figure out.
Pretty much. So, yeah. Guys, so remember, if you want to win one just like this, go ahead and comment below and subscribe and tell us what have you been doing to deal with all this craziness.
How are you coping with it?
And we will select one of you and send you out a kit just like this.
Yes.
All right, guys. Thanks. Let's keep calm and make on.